All right, we good?
We're good.
All right, who's first?
Is this a new vest? Let me ask you that.
Same vest from last year, but I do have some new ones. Thank you, Miguel and Tyler. But we're going to wait for the games for those.
So high expectations this season, right?
We always have high expectations, but yeah, we're excited for the season. Excited to see some of the new faces in with the old and see what we got this year.
Now that the team is officially constructed from training camp, what do you think top to bottom, how the roster looks heading into training camp?
You know, I think obviously anytime you add a six-time All-Star to what you already have in DeMar, expectations go up. But, you know, that's nothing new, I think, for us. As we talked about when we first came in, we want to get to this point where that's the expectation every year, no matter who's putting on the Kings jersey. But certainly I think excitement around the community, around the organization for DeMar to join this group.
Monty, it's been pretty consistent since the acquisition of Domantas Sabonis of this group spending time together off the court. To see Domas go and spend some time working with DeMar one-on-one, how much do you enjoy seeing the team coming together and ready to get to work so early?
Yeah, it's always anytime your guys like each other, that helps. But those two in particular, two cerebral players, are going to play off each other. And for them to get a head start is great. But, you know, really we're excited to get the guys on the floor here tomorrow. And, you know, we're talking about how media day is so exciting. It's like the start of things. But really we're looking for getting the guys on the floor, which is tomorrow. And then, you know, first game on the ninth.
Earlier this summer, we talked to Domas, and one of the things he said was talking about learning to incorporate and play with DeMar DeRozan, but also how much is the acquisition of DeMar DeRozan about him coming in and fitting seamlessly with what the team already does.
I think that's going to be up to Mike, how he figures out how those guys fit. But, you know, I think anytime you bring in these guys, like I said, cerebral players, smart players, guys with great feel, you can add De'Aaron and Keegan and on, you know, that's what Jay Chiriano and Mike have kind of built our offense around. So all five guys on the floor are going to have to be able to make a play, have to be able to sacrifice at times where somebody else has the ball, move without the ball, get offensive rebounds, anything you can do to affect that end of the floor. And then we all know Mike's going to make sure the five guys are in sync and unison on the other end.
You have the summer. Do you feel like at that time that this is ultimately the type of team you were going to be putting together, or does this kind of come out of nowhere for you guys?
I think we're always canvassing to see how we can get better. And I think one thing is, if we look at the West, I mean, I don't know, there's 12, 13 teams that are going to expect to be in the playoffs, and I'm pretty sure that we still only get 8 spots. So we knew we had to figure out a way to get better. That can come externally, which DeMar and, you know, Jordan McLaughlin, Jay McDaniels, we got Devin Carter, obviously, in the draft. You know, those guys are going to help, but also internally, and guys continuing to grow. We have a relatively young team or in their prime, so we hope these guys continue to have better and better seasons. And then, you know, we got a great coaching staff who we're able to lock up, and, you know, their job's going to be to get us back to the playoffs.
Monty, you have a couple of players, a couple of injuries last week. Just want to know, you know, what type of concern that is, and will it be available, you know, by the time the season starts?
Yeah, obviously wish everybody was healthy and ready to go tomorrow. We got a couple guys that, you know, are a couple weeks from being reevaluated. Hopefully that reevaluation is positive. You know, Devin, I think, is the one guy that's going to be out a little more extended. But we also have a roster we're excited about. We got guys that, you know, are either young and we're hoping to find that they can fit in the rotation. They have an opportunity to maybe step up. And, you know, we have other guys that have been in the league a long time. And so they're going to figure out a way to fit in. And Mike's going to be able to move those pieces around. But, you know, we'll keep evaluating those guys. But, you know, we have a roster 1 to 17, 18, whatever, you know, they give us these days that, you know, we think can contribute. And we're excited to see what some of the guys who haven't had a big opportunity can do.
Monty, what do you expect this team to look like offensively, given the addition of DeMar to what's been a pretty potent group over the past couple of years?
You know, I think we got a chance to be one of the best offenses in the league. You know, anytime you got guys like De'Aaron, Domas, DeMar, you know, I think one thing is it's going to be harder for teams to guard us, especially down the stretch of games. You know, I don't know, you're going to put somebody on De'Aaron, somebody on DeMar, you still got, you know, Keegan, Kevin, Malik, Domas, all these guys that can score. So, you know, we'll be able to put units out there where all five guys can be tough to defend. But, you know, we know the tenets. We want to play fast. We've been pretty good at that. I'd like to get even higher than we were last year. I think we were still top 10, but this should be a top 5 unit in the offensive pace, not the the pace that maybe some websites have. Like, we're concerned with our offensive pace. We actually want our defense to slow the other team down, so sometimes that affects that number. But we have the fastest guy in the league in De'Aaron, so that's going to be a big part of what we do. We've got guys that can score at all three levels. Obviously, DeMar is, you know, a maestro in the mid-range. We've got three-point shooters. We've got guys that can get to the rim. We're gonna hit the glass. We're gonna offensive rebound. We're gonna find second chance points. So, you know, we're gonna attack you from all angles.
And how exciting is that to have two of the top clutch scorers in the league? And how big of a piece is DeMar's free throw rate and percentage?
Yeah, I think when you get down to the end of games, to the playoffs, to these kind of big moments, you know, things tend to, you know, defenses are more locked in. Whatever the reason. It becomes, you know, sometimes you got to have guys that can just go one-on-one and score. And, you know, we definitely have two guys that can really do that. But also Domas has shown that he can do that. We know Malik, what he can do. You know, Keegan coming into his own. So, you know, those guys be able to play off the other two who have been in the clutch scoring leaders. So, you know, we're excited to see what those guys can do, not just for themselves, but what they'll open up for others.
Monty, I know length was an issue last year, specifically against the Pelicans. Do you feel like you addressed the length issue that you guys were dealing with last year? And if so, how do you feel like you addressed it?
Well, I think for us, like, we're going to have to beat teams that, you know, the Pelicans have some length that they can throw at us. I think one thing is now they got one other tough offensive guy that they're going to have to throw somebody at. And so, you know, that may free up De'Aaron to – you know, have a little more space or whatever. But we certainly have some guys that I think you'll see that are a little bigger, longer. Jalen McDaniels certainly has some length. You know, obviously Alex Len coming back is a big seven-footer in the middle. But, you know, at the same time, we're going to have to go to our strengths, and teams are going to have to adapt to us as well.
What are you kind of, I don't know, curious most about with this roster and how maybe the next few weeks ahead kind of play out?
Yeah, I think anytime you add new faces, it's just how is that going to fit? You know, we're confident those guys will figure it out every time. You know, I've been around a team where you add a really good player. Those guys have, and I think with DeMar, he's now been, this is going to be his fourth organization. He's continued to fit in around completely different styles and different types of players. So, you know, we may be a little different than what he has, but I think that has the chance to be even, you know, more of a positive. So, you know, I think that's definitely something we're excited to see. Certainly some uncertainty there, but, you know, pretty optimistic about what that's going to look like.
Well, Michael had his own sort of list of, like, players and competitions or battles. What do you see as sort of maybe the biggest battle here in training camp that may or may not play out?
Yeah, I don't know about battles. Mike gets to make all the decisions on who plays and all that. I think my job and our front office's job is to give Mike a bunch of options. And so that means whether guys are battling for positions or, like we said, we're dealing with some injuries, that guys have opportunity to play. You know, I think that's the key. And then Mike and Jay and Doug and Luke, their job is to fit those pieces together on a nightly basis, whether that's based on the opponent, based on injury, based on how guys are playing. But I think we got guys up and down the roster that can contribute and fit around each other well.
You mentioned Keegan briefly. I know every offseason it seems like we talk about him and his quote-unquote leap that he can make. What are your expectations for Keegan this year?
I think, you know, the expectation for Keegan is he continues to grow like he's been doing. I think I've said before, the really interesting and cool thing for me about Keegan is what he was at Iowa was not at all what he was his first year, and he came in at exactly what we needed as a rookie to come in and contribute to a 48 win playoff team and break the rookie 3-point record, which in college he was really more of an inside the arc scorer. And then last year he goes and figures out how to become one of the, I think, the best wing defenders in the Western Conference, which again he was playing really more of a 4 or 5 in college. So I think, I don't know what Keegan's going to do this year. I just know it's going to be something good because that's what he does. He works all summer. He works his butt off, and he finds ways to contribute whatever we need.
What have you learned, if anything, about DeMar in terms of being like a, you know, a tone setter, a culture guy, somebody who can bring an element of, like, leadership?
Yeah, I think DeMar and me and DeMar and our organization were new in our relationship, but from July till now, everything we've seen about DeMar is just the veteran, the leader, you know, just kind of the culture builder he is, and that lines up with everything I think we've seen publicly, everybody here has seen publicly from DeMar along his stop. So he's been a lot of places, he's learned how to win, and I think he's going to bring that. I think it's his 16th season, so he's going to bring a lot of that to our relatively young team here.
Monty,
De'Aaron and Domas still fairly early in their careers. Like, how much do you think they can still take another step in their games and what that could look like?
Yeah, I think always, you know, these guys can figure out. Just look at DeMar. I mean, DeMar's still making strides in his game as he enters his 16th season. So, De'Aaron, we've seen last year, led the league in steals. Domas with whatever his crazy double-double streak. Like, these guys continue to figure out ways that they can, you know, make themselves better, but really make their teammates better. And, you know, I think for us, we need anybody all up and down the roster to continue to make strides. And to compete in the West, that's how it's going to have to be. We've seen the teams that have been able to come out and advance, you know, they have maybe a surprise player. You know, I want to point to Keon last year, who was started in the G League, and by the end of the year he was starting for us in the play-in tournament. So we need more of those as well. So at the top end of the roster all the way down, we need guys that can continue to take steps for us.
Thanks, everyone.
Thanks, Mike.
Thanks, guys.